It's still raining.
It's just dark everywhere in the house. It's supposed to be like this all week. Hi, and welcome back to my next video. It's a real cat in hat day out here in Jupiter Farms. You can see the rain behind me. It's been raining for about 36 hours, and it's supposed to rain all week and just get heavier and heavier and heavier. The ground's already really saturated. I'll show you some videos later on of what's going on out here in the yard, but it's a good day to do some other stuff. I've got some videos I need to edit. I need to put my chickens out. Of course, I need to feed my squirrels. They eat right out there, so I'll take care of them right now. And I also need to practice my guitar. Tonight's open mic night at the Double Roads Tavern, and I got my guitar lesson tomorrow, so it's a perfect day to have a little extra coffee and get rolling. This is the bowl I normally feed them in. It's full of water. So we'll put them right there. And look down the fence. No squirrels that way. No squirrels that way. What's up?
What's up?
You think it's gonna be a rainy day today?
Huh?
I think so. Think it's gonna be a rainy day today?
What?
Rain? Oh, not coming out in the rain, huh? You want me to come into the garage, huh? If you for some, you're gonna get the petting, but I still have to come in the garage. Is that right? Let's go down to dog cam level. Okay, so I got a little break in the rain here. And although everything is flooded, I think I'm gonna go out here and let my chickens out while I have the chance. This is my milkweed project. I keep hoping I'm going to get some monarch butterflies to come by, but it's a perfect day to put them in the ground so they can get nice and tall. So that's going to be one of my projects for today. Let's go check on the chickens. Okay, the chickens are out. I put their food up inside the run so it doesn't get rained on today. And let me see what else is going on here. Well, it stopped raining for just a second, so I think I'm going to take advantage of this and go plant some of my milkweed. So, put this up just in case because it comes on really quickly. I'm going to get the shovel, and I'm going to put one of them right over here where I can see it off my back porch. And then I'm going to put a couple out further away, and then one right over here where I can also see it from my back porch. I mean, if you were a monarch butterfly looking for milkweed, wouldn't you say this looks like a great place to stop? Let me go up here and get a shovel. Well, I was going to plant it right here, but that is a little live oak coming up here, and I don't want to disturb it, so I'm going to dig a hole over here. So I wanted to plant the milkweed because it's supposed to rain all week. And that's a really good time to transplant stuff. These plants are pretty big right now and they need a lot of moisture, so this is a good time for me to get them in the ground. So let's go over here and grab two of them. I can't believe we don't have any monarchs here yet. These are really great plants. You can see why I want to do it when it's raining a lot here. See all the roots here? They're already really, really pot bound. They need to get in the ground. This is a perfect time to do it because the rain will help settle them in. So I put this hole right here and I'll still be able to see it from my porch. Okay, they should settle in nicely there. It's supposed to rain really heavily all week. So that should give them a good chance to get started. I'm kind of disappointed that monarch butterflies haven't shown up yet. So if anybody knows how to call them or attract them, let me know down below in the comments. I'd appreciate it. So that's plant number three. Okay, there's plant number four. So one of the really cool things about living in Jupiter Farms is I've got an acre and a half out here and I can do what I want. What we do is we drop organic recycling material as well as things with seeds. We throw them in here and a lot of times stuff sprouts by itself. So let me show you some of the stuff that's come up in here. First of all, I don't know if you can tell what that is. That's sugar cane that my son put here and it's growing right outside the fence. This is really cool. I don't know if you'll be able to tell what it is, but I had a papaya that had hundreds of seeds in it. So I brought it out here and put all the seeds in the garden. They've all sprouted. It's not a monarch, but it's a good sign. Okay, these are some gigantic bromeliads. They've already flowered. Here's what the big flower looks like. So this is really just a pup. In other words, after the older one, which is right around here, dies, then the pups come up. And there's my new milkweed. Here's a mango tree. Hope it's one of my dad's. And then over here we have, here's some papaya trees that have already come up. There's one. There's another one right there. Another one right there. And then right here, there's another set of papaya seeds that have sprouted. Okay, so I planted four of the milkweed so far. Empty pot, shovel. I've got two more left. I'm gonna put them around in the front yard. I'll probably leave one where I can watch it from my back porch. And then I'm gonna put the other one in the front yard. Oh, by the way, let me show you something really cool. This is a little pine tree. I don't know if you'll be able to see this or not. You see that right there? Every year after the pine cones open up, they drop the pine seeds on the ground. So I've gone around the yard and marked a couple. Here's another one up here. There's three pine trees right here. I'm trying to encourage them to grow so we can have more trees. Another thing when you're digging holes in your yard like this, you have to be careful of irrigation lines. I don't have any electrical lines here, but I've got irrigation lines that I have to be careful of. Okay, so I've got five of the six milkweed put in the ground. Should be great, and it looks like there's more rain on the way. Let me show you the sky. There you go. Rain is coming. In fact, it's already raining on the camera right now. Okay, so we got a break in the rain here. I got the chickens fed. I got the squirrels fed. I think it's a perfect time to go in and make a little extra coffee and then go down and practice my guitar, and then I'm going to come back out here in the back porch and do some more editing. The back porch is just beautiful and it's kind of fun to watch it rain. Playing at the Double Roads open mic on Monday nights, and tonight I'm playing with a friend of mine named Kyle, and he wants to play Amy by Pure Prairie Leaf, so I'm working on that one. So I took a break from my guitar practice because it started raining, and I wanted you to see just how hard it can rain in South Florida. Well, it stopped raining, but the sun hasn't come out. In fact, it's supposed to rain all this week, so I'm not expecting any kind of a break in the weather. I got my guitar practicing done, and I think I'm gonna spend this afternoon out here on the patio working on videos and getting some editing done. Then I'll make dinner, and I'm heading over to Double Roads tonight for the open mic. I see a lot of friends there that I really like. Thanks for watching. I really appreciate it. If you enjoyed the video, you might want to subscribe and give me a thumbs up. It really helps the channel. Till the next video, have a great afternoon.